Hi everybody, we are the UIC chapter of Asian Pharmacists Association, and we are here today to present blood pressure self-monitoring by our special project committee. So first off, to introduce, I'm Anna and I am a P2.
My name is Eileen and I'm a P2.
My name is Anne and I'm a P1.
My name is Chloe and I'm a P1.
My name is Jerry and I am P1.
My name is Jared and I'm a P2.
My name is Justin and I'm a P1.
My name is Melody, I'm also a P1.
First, let's talk about the objectives of our presentation. First, we're going to introduce blood pressure. Then we're going to talk about the signs and symptoms of high blood pressure and low blood pressure. Then we'll talk about how to understand blood pressure readings and how to measure blood pressure. Then we'll talk about ways that are non-pharmacological to control blood pressure. And then we'll talk about community resources that can be used to manage blood pressure. So blood pressure is a major issue in the United States. 45% of adults have high blood pressure, but only 1 in 4 adults with high blood pressure have it under control. High blood pressure increases the risk of disease and stroke, which are the leading causes of death in the United States. High blood pressure was a primary or contributing cause for almost 500,000 deaths in the United States in 2018. Around 1 in 5 adults either don't know they have high blood pressure or do not report it, so that percentage could be higher.
High blood pressure is termed the silent killer because it usually develops over time with no warning signs or symptoms. The only way to tell if you have high blood pressure is if you measure your blood pressure. Reasons someone may have high blood pressure could be from an unhealthy lifestyle choice or health conditions such as diabetes, obesity, or pregnancy. Low blood pressure is when the heart, brain, and other parts of the body don't get enough blood. Some people have low blood pressure all the time and it might be normal for them. Others experience a sudden drop in blood pressure or have low blood pressure that may be linked to a health problem. For many people, low blood pressure goes unnoticed. They just feel lightheaded or tired. Other symptoms could include blurry vision, headache, neck or back pain, nausea, and heart palpitations. Older adults have a higher risk for symptoms of low blood pressure because they're at a higher risk for falls and fainting. But patients should only worry about having low blood pressure if they're having symptoms as well.
When measuring your blood pressure, there are two numbers for you to look at. The first, or top number, is your pressure when your heart beats, called the systolic pressure. The second, or bottom number, measures the force of blood in your arteries while your heart is relaxed, filling with blood between beats.
Your blood pressure is considered relatively low if your first number is less than 90 and your second number is less than 60. In this case, it's totally fine unless you're symptomatic. A normal ideal range for blood pressure would be for the first number to be between 90 and 120, and for the second number to be between 60 and 80. Pre-high blood pressure is observed when the first number is between 120 and 130, or when the second number is less than 80. High blood pressure stage 1 is considered when the first number is between 130 and 140, or when the second number is between 80 and 90. Hypertension or high blood pressure is experienced when your first number is at 140 or higher, or when the second number is at 90 or higher. A hypertensive crisis is considered when your first number is at 180 or higher and or the second number is at 120 or higher. In that case, please seek medical advice immediately.
A single high or low reading is not an immediate cause for alarm. If you get a reading that is slightly or moderately higher or lower than normal, take your blood pressure a few more times or switch to different arm to measure again, and consult your healthcare professional to verify if there is a health concern or whether there may be any issues with your monitor. Also, make sure to record these readings down in order to present it at your next doctor appointment.
If your blood pressure reading suddenly exceeds 180 over 120, please wait for 5 minutes and then test again. If your readings are still unusually high, please contact your doctor immediately. You could be experiencing a hypertensive crisis. If your blood pressure is higher than 180 over 120 and you're experiencing signs of possible organ damage, such as chest pain, shortness of breath, back pain, numbness or weakness, change in vision, difficulty speaking, do not wait to see if your pressure comes down on its own.
Please call 911 immediately.
To monitor your blood pressure using an automatic blood pressure monitor, find a quiet place to sit with a table and a chair with a good back support. When you are ready, sit quietly for a few minutes, place your feet flat on the floor, and rest your arm on the tabletop, even with your heart. Extend your arm with the palm facing upwards and place the cuff 1 inch above the bend of your elbow. Place the cuff tight enough so that 2 fingertips can slip into the top edge of the cuff. To get started, press the start button and remain still and silent as the machine begins to measure. The cuff will inflate and deflate while it measures your blood pressure. The monitor will display your blood pressure in a minute. Rest quietly for 1 to 2 minutes before your next measurement. Measurements should be taken twice a day. The first measurement should be in the morning before eating or taking any medications, and the second in the evening. Each time you measure, take 2 or 3 readings to make sure your results are accurate. Please be sure to record your blood pressure readings in a log or book and bring it to your next primary care visit so your doctor can utilize it to continuously improve your health.
With blood pressure, many drugs have been developed to control it, but there are also methods that are not drug-related and are just as effective. According to one study, high blood pressure has some correlation to poor mental health. Feelings of depression, anxiety, and stress are all major proponents to increase blood pressure, and so we suggest activities that counter them. Yoga, getting more sleep, and exercising normally are great ways to reduce stress and anxiety. Additionally, managing your stress appropriately by prioritizing your tasks and having people you can talk to about any issues you are having, instead of keeping them to yourself, can have a large impact too. Lastly, eating healthier meals with lots of variety can improve your body's health by giving it the necessary nutrients and energy for the day. The majority of these modifications are aimed towards improving mental health, which then can lead to improvements in blood pressure. But of course, activities such as exercising and eating healthier will help majorly as well.
In a case that you don't have any blood pressure monitoring devices at home, there are many community resources you could use to get blood pressure monitored. Nearly every community pharmacy has blood pressure monitoring machines that allow people to have their blood pressure checked either by themselves or by the pharmacist. In addition to blood pressure tests, some pharmacies also offer comprehensive health testings, which could include cholesterol, blood glucose, and blood composition. So if you are planning to check your blood pressure in a community pharmacy, you can also reach out to see if they offer comprehensive health testings. In addition, most of the community pharmacies, such as CVS and Walgreens, provide free language services to people whose primary language is not English. By simply Googling multi-languages services for the pharmacy you're going to, the phone number associated with the certain language will be displayed.
Aside from community pharmacies, free blood pressure readings can be taken at health fairs hosted by student organizations like APA. Of course, with COVID going on, there has been less frequent health fairs. Health fairs normally provide free blood pressure, glucose, cholesterol, and BMI screenings for patients in different communities. Chinatown and the Korean-Swedish Covenant Hospital health fairs, to name a few. Resources that are readily available within the comfort of your own home include the official website of the American Heart Association. This website provides a lot of useful information, such as basic blood pressure facts, understanding readings, health risks associated with high blood pressure, and learning how to self-monitor. A quick 6-question survey can be taken to access personalized health suggestions. Also, current health info such as COVID guidance, healthy eating, fitness, and stress management are found on the website. So here are the references that we use to provide this presentation. If you're interested in learning more, please feel free to use these references. This was APA Special Projects Committee, and thank you for listening to our presentation.
Hello, everyone. We would like to thank you for your time watching this video. My name is Chia Lee, and I'm currently a P3 and the Vice President of Asian Pharmacists Association. I'm the person in charge of overseeing the Special Projects Committee and the video editing. Please feel free to contact us if you have any suggestions or improvements. Once again, please subscribe our channel and stay tuned for more videos.